last week I changed the setup of my Specialized Able touring bike and actually decided to tour it around Switzerland a little bit. Well, it was only 4 days, but some good K's and some nice elevation. And actually got to see a bit of the Tour de Suisse, as you may know, stage race, a world tour level stage race in Switzerland. It's always with a lot of mountains included and really hard racing. So it was pretty cool to see. I actually got to see a bike of Marc Soler from the Movistar team. He really is aspiring to be a GC rider, I think. He managed to really get some great results in the last couple of years and proved himself worthy of really a Grand Tour GC ride, I think. And there he is to say, will you check out my bike for a little review? And I said, no worries, Marc Soler. So I got to check it out, the Movistar. Quite obviously it's the Aeroad with the aerodynamic seat post and the aero shapes, as you can see. And also there's integrated the handlebar and stem cockpit combination. His sticker there, Soler Mark 93, is Insta tag, I'm pretty sure. Maybe also his Twitter tag, I don't know. Zip303 Firecrest. Actually nothing really special there on his bike, maybe except of the Continental Competition Pro Limited ALX 25mm tubulars, limited to the professionals, I think, with the ALX, meaning they have a latex inner tube, so they will be even lighter. And the competition being a great tire in general, but the ALX Pro Limited will just be on that next level, of course, for the professionals. And we see SRAM Red Axis group set, the ETAP 2x12. Nothing really out of the ordinary there for a top-notch group set. The cassette looks rather small for nowadays riding. And those pictures were taken at the day of quite of a hilly stage, actually, with the Col du Pion and the last climb being in the canton of Valais, and the valleys where the mountains are pretty steep and high. So actually I was surprised that Marc Soler didn't opt for something lighter. Also going for the 5239, I think. So pretty standard setup actually. Of course it wasn't really high mountain stage, so you wouldn't put a compact on, I'm sure. With the new cassettes from SRAM, with the 12-speed cassettes, they do cassettes like 10 to 33, so that can actually find a really nice gearing. Hydraulic disc brakes, of course, and you see those zip wheels. Pretty interesting that they have the traditional spokes, not straight pull. Maybe makes a bit of an impression that it's a cheap wheel. Well, zip isn't the highest quality of wheels. If you have worked with them, you will have seen that the hubs can get pretty rough pretty quickly. I'm not really a fan of zip, to be honest. Never was. Well, I never owned a pair, but I worked with them, and just by having them in my hands, there are other wheels out there that I would prefer. Pretty aggressive setup of Mark here. Slammed the stem all the way down. Only the little top cap is left. As most of the professionals, he will ride one or two sizes smaller of a frame size that would be normal for his size, in order to get really aggressive down aerodynamically in the front. Lizard skin spar tape, physique saddle, as it looks like, and the little transponder. So pretty normal setup, I would say. Of course you see that the cockpit is not all integrated one, so the cables are visible. That's due to I'm sure Mathieu van der Poel's encounter that he had. His handlebar just broke at the STI, where the STI is clamped. I have made a video about that, you could check it out. Always pretty cool to see a road bike from a professional rider that close. You see that it's pretty actually thrashed up. Of course it's always cleaned either the night before or the day before the stage, so they are always shiny, but if you check out the little details, they are pretty thrashed up. So you see that they work really hard with them. They don't take care like your Sunday coffee rider. They really thrash those things up, in a good way, of course. Pretty interesting to see. So that's it. Thank you for checking out this little video. Hope you enjoyed it, and see you in the next one.